My name is Joe Barnby. I'm a doctoral researcher and mental health professional studying the brain mechanisms of belief formation. Beliefs can be mercurial and strange. They can divide nations and claim lives. We might think we're impervious to odd beliefs, but given enough time, I could probably identify one or two strange beliefs that you hold. However, for some, beliefs become so fixed and bizarre that they might require clinical support. Medically, these are known as delusions. While there is some evidence that dopamine plays an important role in how delusions are formed, it doesn't account for why delusions tend to have similar content. For example, the majority of delusions are centered around persecutory ideas, like the belief that the CIA has implanted a chip in your brain. A good way to approach this problem is to look at first how healthy people form beliefs, but this requires a way to measure them. Our research team has developed a new inventory to measure beliefs about politics, morality, science, the paranormal, and religion. We wanted to assess whether our newly developed measure is accurate and reliable, and we also wanted to get a good profile of beliefs and values in the general population. And this includes how much of the population agrees with certain beliefs, how interested they are in a certain belief, and how relative they think these beliefs are to themselves. We included these factors because a key observation with delusions is how interesting and self-relevant the delusional beliefs are to people. It's not merely a case that these beliefs are held at a distance, they're often an integral aspect of their daily experience. We distributed our questionnaire to over 1,500 people online. We use an online platform called Prolific Academic to source a wide range of ages, ethnicities, and socioeconomic characteristics to make sure our sample was as representative as possible. And we collected two types of data, cross-sectional and longitudinal. Cross-sectional means that we looked at beliefs of our population as a whole at one time point. We performed some statistical analyses to see whether our inventory was reliable and how the agreement, interest, and self-relevance of each type of belief related to one another. We also took some people from our population and asked them the same questions again after 48 hours and then after 3.5 months to see whether their beliefs had changed. First of all, we found that beliefs are multidimensional. People might be interested and feel a belief is relevant to them no matter whether they disagree or agree with a particular belief. We also found that agreement with religious belief was highly correlated with paranormal belief, and that belief in the use of science as a tool for discovering truth was correlated with more liberal values. Interestingly, morality wasn't correlated with any of the other themes of belief, and we also found that over 48 hours, beliefs about morality were far more likely to change, whereas the other themes were fairly stable over time. However, if we look at changes over 3.5 months, all beliefs become more variable, with beliefs about science and politics changing the most. Religious beliefs and paranormal beliefs remain the most consistent over this time. From our results, we can now say that our measure is reliable and useful in studies aimed to experimentally manipulate beliefs or look at beliefs in individuals in different settings. Not only can we look at how someone might agree or disagree with a belief, but because we can assess different dimensions of belief, we look at the persistence to which people hold certain beliefs as well. Our curious finding that morality doesn't correlate with other beliefs might mean that one's moral beliefs are fairly independent of whether they're religious, particularly liberal, or care much for science. And this is interesting as it might suggest a different mechanism or context where moral beliefs are cultivated and installed. Importantly, beliefs vary over time to different degrees. This might suggest that some topics of belief are harder to change and shift, and that others might be more susceptible to daily life events. In a time where opposing beliefs cause social rifts, it's now more important than ever to understand why we believe the things that we do. More importantly, for those who find their beliefs making them unwell, understanding the mechanisms of how beliefs are formed might hold the key to preventing and pacifying the more distressing or damaging ones. Our new measure opens the door for experimental and epidemiological study to drive at the core of how and why we believe. The trick as researchers is now to keep our own beliefs flexible so we can allow this data to lead the way. Thanks for listening.